The Invoices and Credits module in CH50 Accounts is an easy way to generate your customer invoices. You can generate both product and service invoices, and credit notes can be generated in the same way. It fully integrates with your customer records and any products and services that you've also set up. Invoices can be printed and emailed, and the format of these can be customized to suit your business requirements. For example, you might add your company logo and your trading terms. Let's look at how you enter a service invoice. So we start by going into Invoices and Credits, and then from the toolbar at the top, click New Invoice. The type box should be set to Invoice, and from the format menu, we change it from Product to Service. You then just need to ensure that the date's correct, choose the relevant customer account, and we'll just use the one that's selected in this example. You then enter your details and the amount. To check or amend any of the background details relating to the invoice item, you click the little Finder button attached to the details. This displays the Edit Item Line box, where you can enter things like quantity, unit prices, amend the discount percentage or enter a discount amount, and also amend nominal codes, tax codes and departments. You should note that the nominal code and tax code and department are picked up from the customer record that you've specified, but these can be amended if required. Once you've made your amends, click OK. That takes us back to the main invoice screen. There's also a number of tabs down the left-hand side, so we can enter order information, photo details, and also payment details. In this case, we're just going to save the invoice. We could then start creating additional invoices. However, in this example, we're just going to close out to return to the Invoices and Credits list. With the invoice that we've just entered highlighted, we could click Print, we can email it to our customer. However, to push it across to the customer's account, we need to update it to the ledgers. So with it selected, we click Update Ledgers. We'll leave the Update Ledgers report set to Preview, click OK. This can obviously be printed and emailed and saved if required. However, in this case, we're just going to close it. The invoice now shows as being posted, meaning that the invoice has been updated to the customer activity. When you go into an invoice, to save you having to choose the service invoice type each time, we can actually set that. And to do this, you go into Settings, choose Invoice and Order Defaults, and set the default invoice to Service Invoice. If we then click OK, and then go to Generate a New Invoice, the format box now defaults to service, meaning that you don't have to select that each and every time.